Hello designers, in today's video I'll be covering Affinity Designer's latest update version 2.6. I'll walk you through what's new and any improvements. Let's get into it. First up is the pencil tool, and this time we have more options for auto close. So if I just go into the pencil tool now, shortcut N, if we go up to the context toolbar, you see it says auto close off. So if I go ahead and draw out and just let go, you see the lines aren't connecting there. So that's with it off, it's not auto closing. I'll delete that, go up to the context toolbar and click near. You see there's far and always as well. So if I click on near, now I can click and draw out again. And you see a little red dot there. If I go close to it, it's like a little magnet or a little chain link, and let go, it connects them and completes the circle. I'll delete that again. Now we'll head up to auto close and far and see what difference that makes. So I'm gonna click and draw around, and it should connect a little bit further away. There we go, same icon, but just further away, and it's completed the circle. I'll delete that, and then obviously you know what this one is. Always, click, drag, and even if I end up here, let go, it will auto connect. And I will also mention that if auto close is on always, and you click and drag around, you can leave it here if you want, like last time, but you could go closer in and that chain link icon will appear and it will be complete. Let's move on. And another update to the pencil tool is the smoothness feature. Now, this feature is going to allow you to dictate how smooth your curve or your line is going to be before or immediately after you draw out your line. So if we head on up to the context toolbar, you'll see there it is, smoothness. Now it defaults to 50%. But you can go ahead and drag it down to zero via this slider here, or you can head on over to the word here and just click on it and drag left or right like this. So we'll drag it all the way down to zero. And just to note, when using this, you should uncheck stabilizer over here. Okay, let's give it a shot. So I'm going to click and drag out and draw some kind of like spiral shape here. And there we go. You can see there are many nodes and it's not very smooth because we put it on smoothness 0%. So if I go ahead and delete that and we go up to smoothness, and I'll drag this up all the way to 100% and I'll try again. I'll just drag and draw out that same kind of shape again and let go. And you can see, even though I didn't do the best job, there are way less nodes in there. The lines are smoother. And basically, this feature works by repositioning, adding or removing nodes on the curve to affect the smoothing results. Now, another thing is, I've just drawn out this shape, okay? I can go up to smoothness now and click on it and just drag it down to zero, and it will show me what it would look like if the smoothness wasn't applied. So I kind of get to decide what I want. But this only works immediately after you draw it. So if I clicked away from it and clicked on it and tried again with the smoothness, it's not going to work. Okay, let's continue. Another update to the pencil tool, which is also available in the pen tool, is style. And basically this feature allows you to activate or deactivate your stroke or fill just with a click of a button. And they're up here in the context toolbar if you're in the pen or pencil tool. And you can see up here it says use fill. That used to be here before, but it was a little checkbox like you see on the right hand side. So in the pencil tool, I just click and draw out some kind of shape, and I've got my stroke there. And I used to be able to go up and just click on use fill. Now I can do it with the icon. And this is the new thing here, use line style. So I can uncheck that to remove the stroke or check it to reveal the stroke. And these are all based on whatever settings you have in your colors tab over here. You can see the fill and the stroke color over there. And the stroke settings here, you can change it to another kind of style, maybe a dashed line style. And then you could just click and drag out and it will be there. And maybe you don't want the stroke now. You could just uncheck use line style. Okay, moving on. And with this new update, the node tool also gets a little bit of love. And now you have the ability to change the nodes from sharp to smooth by just double clicking on them. Very easy. So the way I used to do it before is press Alt or Option and click. So I've got this wave shape here. I'm going to switch to the node tool. And I used to be able to just click on it. Well, I still can. And press Option or Alt and just click once. And it would turn it into a sharp node. That also works on the handles over here, so Option or Alt and click, and it's a sharp node. So I'll just press Command Z to go back. Now it's much easier. So I could just double click on it. It's a sharp node. I can use it on the handle over here, double click, sharp node. So I could just go around on the fly. This is very useful now, much easier because I don't need to press any other keys on the keyboard. Okay, moving on. The new update to the color picker tool allows you to automatically apply a picked color. So if I take this gray circle and I want to apply this color over here, the old way I'd do it is I'd select the gray color, I go up to the color picker tool here, I click it, I drag it down, and I'd sample that color just by letting go. And then it would change this color well at the top here. And then I just click once on it and it applies it. So this new update allows you to just do it automatically, basically. And it's much needed, I think. So I'm going to press Command Z and we'll do it the new way. So I'm just going to click on the color picker tool, sample the color, just basically let go. And it's applied it. I'll press Command Z because if you want to stick to the old way of doing it, maybe you're just used to it that way, you could just head on up to the color picker tool, click it, drag it, and before you let go, just hold down Option or Alt on the keyboard and let go. And then you can go up to the color picker tool and just click once. There we go. Let's move on. The new update for the brushes is now they are searchable. So this works in the vector brush or pixel persona in the pixel brushes. So if you head on over to the brushes tab, there's now a little box here. So let's say you wanted to search for one of your brushes, the snake. I'll just type in snake and there is the snake. And this is really handy. So if I just selected one of my strokes here, and let's say I wanted to apply the cat one, but there's like hundreds of brushes. I could just type in here, cat, and there it is. I just click once, and now we have a big sausage cat there. There he is. Okay, let's move on. And if you head to Affinity's own website, you can see what else is new in version 2.6 for Affinity Photo, Affinity Publisher, Affinity Designer. I've covered most of the important ones for Affinity Designer, but if you have the other programs as well, this might be useful for you to check out. You can see there's some other minor changes to the stroke width tool here. And basically that concludes this tutorial. See you on the next one.